What's up, YouTube fam? Welcome back to my channel. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Karrington, and I want to thank you for joining me today. Happy 2021. Happy New Year. We have finally made it out of 2020. Thank goodness. Obviously, last year was a crazy year, as we all know. And even with all the craziness and the pandemic and all that's happened, I still had quite a few blessings and a lot of lessons that I learned and a lot that I am blessed and thankful for. Just this morning with my older sister, I decided that I wanted to plan out some of my goals for this new year. My older sister Danielle really helped me out today in planning what I want to do, what I want to achieve for this 2021. First thing I did was I grabbed a journal or planner that I feel that I'm not going to lose. This is a planner that I got off of Amazon called the Legend Planner. It was pretty affordable. The cool thing about it is you can decide when you want your planner to start, right? There's no actual official year. Everything is blank. So you get to fill out when your week starts, when the month starts, all of that. In this planner, they have a section called My Dreams right at the beginning. So I just decided to write down my goals list right here in the beginning of the planner. So I have a few different categories that we decided to make to plan my goals for the new year. I'm somebody who really needs to write things out because I feel like when I write stuff out, I hold myself more accountable than when I just keep it up top here in my head. The first section that I have is physical activity. So this can be anything in terms of maybe joining a gym. For myself, I wrote down taking more dance classes because I am a dancer, but this past year I've really been slacking. Obviously, it was tough taking some classes with COVID, but you know, I see dance studios are making it work, so I really want to get back into taking more dance classes. The next section I have is travel. So these are places that I would like to travel to, you know, COVID permitting, pandemic permitting, as long as things are able to open back up and things are safe. I would really like to go to Atlanta this year because I was supposed to go last year and then COVID happened. LA is also on my list. That's always been on my list for some time. And I'm supposed to go to Portugal with one of my best friends or a few of my best friends. So, you know, we wanted to do that as well, but things happen, life happened. The next section I have is finance. So for me, I just listed things that I would like to accomplish. You know, last year I was able to pay off my credit card debt. So that was a really big achievement for myself. I was very proud of myself there. This year, I do have some other things that I would like to accomplish. So for finances, that could be anything for you, such as student loans, a credit card debt, or maybe saving for an emergency fund, any type of goal that you feel yourself that you want to achieve, I think you could put there definitely. The next section that I have is career. So this can be for you, whether it is you wanna change your job, wanna switch career fields, or what is it that you wanna focus on career-wise this year for yourself. So I've listed a few goals that I have. That could also be maybe requesting a raise. You know, what is it that in your career or in your job that you would like to work on this year, a goal that you have in mind? I do have a couple of things listed. I'm really thinking about where I want to go in terms of my career. If I had it my way, it would be music and YouTube, but you know, who knows? We'll see. Anything could happen. Underneath that, I have personal habits. So for me this past year, I really wanted to work on my femininity and always looking put together anytime I stepped out of the house. Obviously, couldn't really step out of the house that much this year, but anytime I did go either to work or just outside, even to the store, I tried to look put together. Your personal habits could be something as simple as waking up early. Maybe you wanna get up at 7 a.m. instead of 8 a.m. Or a personal habit could also be maybe making sure that your space is clean. For me, I really wanna make sure that I stay on top of keeping my car neat. Sometimes it could get a little messy. I drive a lot. And then the last section that I have is personal projects. So this can be anything that you yourself want to work on in terms of maybe hobbies, any other goals that you see yourself working towards. So for myself, I put down, I want to release an EP by the end of the year. So an EP, an extended play, it's going to be somewhere probably between 4 and 6 songs for myself, but that is something that I really, really want to work on. Last year, I did release a few singles and I'm definitely proud of that, but now it's time for me to do an EP. Gotta get on that. So that's definitely at the top of my list. I also want to get my subscriber count up this year. I'm very happy to say that I finished off 2020 with 150 subscribers. So I couldn't be happier with that. Like, I was really able to focus on my channel this year, and I just want to keep on continuing to grow this channel and just grow with you all. So those are the sections of how I have planned out my 2021, the goals that I have set for myself. Hopefully this video has helped some of you all. Let me know in the comments below some of the goals that you guys will be setting for yourself this year. I want to thank you guys all so much for joining me today in this video. I'm very much looking forward to the new year. If you haven't, be sure to follow me on Instagram and Spotify, as I do make music and I'm looking to grow there. So again, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will catch you in the next one.